Hey man, heard you got that good, you know?
Maybe I do.
You know, maybe you got a little bit of maybe we can have a little bit of an arrangement, man. Actually, you know what? I think I'm good. I'll see you later.
See you around.
I went to my son's Little League game yesterday. It was pretty cool. He hit a good base hit, and then he went around the first base, and then the second base, and then he almost made it to the third base, but they chased him down and tagged him out. After that, we went to Dairy Queen and got some ice cream, and at Dairy Queen, I got a Blizzard. It was pretty good. I think I got Oreo Blizzard there. He got a Reese's. And then we drove to the Grand Canyon, and there was a big ramp there, man. I'm telling you, big ramp on the Grand Canyon. And it just, like, we drove off it, and then these aliens just grabbed us out of nowhere. Like, tractor beam in the air, just grabbed us, man. And we were, like, flying up, man. It was crazy. Dude, Denver Airport, though. I swear, the Illuminati built a bunker underneath it for world fallout. Speaking of Denver Airport...
Dude, this guy, he's nuts, I tell you. You need to come see this.
Bro, I'm telling you, dude. Joe Rogan is the best podcaster. Why aren't you listening to me?
Hey.
Gordon,
hey.
Gordon, cool. What do you want?
Bro.
What do you want?
Chill.
Get off of me! You don't know me! You don't know me!
I regret my past actions of taking PCP. It made me angry. It made me hallucinate and have seizures. It made me forget things, and I have flashbacks still to this day. I went to prison for 5 years after I took PCP and broke a man's arm. I went to rehab for 3, and I've finally gotten clean, and I'm out of the system.
Oh, okay.
You see the game last night?
Yeah, you got pummeled.
No, I didn't.
You were the smallest one out there. Do you even lift, bro?
Yeah, I do.
Whatever.
Yo, you got the stuff?
The stuff, yes sir.
Newest stuff will make you jacked.
Thanks, bro.
Oh, hey, Brandon.
What's up?
Looks like you've been in the weight room.
Oh, yeah.
You're not on steroids, are you?
No, I'm not.
Because that's not cool, bro.
What?
Steroids absolutely destroyed my life. All my relationships went into shambles. All my sporting scholarships, gone. Got thrown off the team. The effects just kept getting worse and worse. Nothing I could do to stop it.
Hey, you got that angel's dust?
Yes, sir.
All right, I got your money. There you go, just like you asked.
Thank you.
I hopped up the plane at LAX with a dream in my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame excess. Am I gonna fit in?
Yeah.
Hey, do you need to drive home?
No, I'm gonna
sure?
drive home.
Dude,
no,
hey, alcohol and cocaine, it can impair your ability to drive. I don't know if that's a good idea.
No, it's fine, dude. It's totally fine.
All right, I'll see you later, man.
Sadly, John died in a car crash later that night due to the cocaine and alcohol in his system. He killed 3 people and crashed my brand new Jeep. This is why you should not take cocaine and alcohol and go driving. Both drugs are very addictive and lower your inhibitions and ability to perform average tasks. And this is why you should only sell cocaine, not do cocaine. These tragic recent events, which has resulted in the loss of 3 of my most valued customers, has made me reflect upon my past and want to reform my ways. It's also helped me recall the dangers of doing illegal drugs. Do not do illegal drugs yourself, or you may end up like any of these 3 tragic people, including poor John here, who I'm holding in this box. Thank you, and good night.